step smells of the sun, and especially wormwood has this specific smell. For the great Sultan Bir Barz, wormwood and its smell is the way to return to the beginning and to his homeland. It was the main topic of creative career for the outstanding film and theater actor, People's Artiste of Kazakhstan, Nurmukhan Janturin. At the end of Sultan by Barz epic by Bulat Mansurov, the Sultan is walking in the steppe, tears up wormwood, rubs it in his hands, and enjoys the flavors of the steppe and the sun as well as the smell of his native land. The audience understood each expressive gesture of the actor, every glance of his deep eyes without words. He keeps silence on the screen a lot. He keeps silence infinitely, eloquently, masterfully, filling the silence with a complex and tragic work of the soul. All those who worked alongside Nurmukhan Janturin called him a master of interior monologue. Janturin is a particular personality, had a very rich inner world. It is possible to watch how he does nothing, just sitting. He had very deep eyes and it was impossible to reach their bottom. He was a special person.
Глубина такая, что до дна не достанешь. Вот такой наполненности был человек.
In the 1960s, Almaty hosted a lot of theater premieres. People who had been going to theaters discussed performances and watched creative life of actors. The audience had been coming to watch the play of Janturin, dip into his fascination, touch his soul, and experience the heart-wrenching complexity of the character's life, the joy and happiness that can only be given by the theater art. Nurmukhan was a great artist and figure of art. Although he starred in a number of films, I am sure that he is a theater artist. The theater has lost a lot when Nurmukhan left the stage. Nurmukhan takes a particular place in theater art. He is a unique actor. He had an inimitable appearance, personality, and voice. He is a true theater artist.
Şimdi de ışkı oyu da, dağısı da nerz tiyatrının artisti Yusuf diyeyim.
В Карагандинском театре он сыграл Макбета. Вся Алмата пришла в театр.
He played a part of Macbeth in the Karaganda Theater, and the whole Almaty had come to see his play. After the performance, I went backstage and saw that a lot of people were congratulating him.
Людей и все его поздравляют, туда в гримерную не заходят, а вот около двери толпа. Я тоже так пробрался, чуть посмотрел, сидит человек, истекает потом.
When I reached him, I saw a person who was drenched in sweat. He'd been working hard while playing different characters. He'd been receiving congratulations, and I saw that he was tired and happy at the same time.
Принимает поздравления, так улыбается, бурчит там что такое, как всегда, как обычно. Вот. И такое облегчение на лице, такая радость и усталость.
Как настоящий лицедей, как настоящий.
He was a true actor who loved the stage. He loved that reality and interaction with the audience. He'd been playing classical roles, including Macbeth and Molière. He was an actor by nature. He was so bright and emotional that it was impossible to replace him.
Даже есть документальный фильм «Жизнь и судьба господина Мольера». Не потому что он сыграл эту роль, а потому что необычная, яркая. Вот как вы говорите, его называли человеком-тайфуном. Он был актер от природы, он был настолько вот эмоциональным, настолько ярким, что его невозможно было не заметить.
Есть рецепт единственный – это…
There is a recipe of success. You should worship the stage. I like Molière because he had worshipped the stage. For example, Couperin said that as long as the sacred fire burns inside you, you should perform at the stage. But when you feel that it is gone, you should leave the theater.
Ну как почувствуешь, что это попу? уходи со сцены.
Filigree acting, dozens of the most striking images created both on the stage and on the screen made Nurmukhan Janturin a legend of the Kazakh culture. When Nurmukhan Janturin came to the All Union Film Festival, the audience greeted him with applause, chanting, Sultan Beybars, Sultan Beybars. He was awarded a special prize and a diploma for outstanding contribution to the profession of an actor. He played such characters as Kodar, Kibek, Kirim, Ayago, Valer, Baron in Little Tragedies, Shokan Valikhanov, Ablaykhanov in The End of the Ottoman Film, Stunning Sultan Beybars, and many others. Nurmukhan Janturin was called the main actor of Aitmatov's prose, and people compared his creative energy with the boiling crater of a volcano. I cannot say that I'm a prophet, a genius, or a teacher, but at the same time, I know the division line between lies and truth. Lie is the most dangerous thing in life. In 1965, in his My Shokan essay, Olja Suleymanov wrote that he was an all-around man. The rare personal charm gave him great friends. A great sense of human dignity allowed him to be treated equally, not dominate and humiliate himself in any environment. He possessed an enthusiastic sensitivity and a wisdom of an old man, a powerful love of life with an incurable mental sorrow. Nurmukhan Janturin played the outstanding scientist and enlightener, the son of the Kazakh nation, Shokan Valikhanov in the film entitled His Time Will Come by Majid Bigalin. One could even say that he didn't play but live the life of Shokan. He remains the paragon of this character until today. The 29-year-old genius was embodied in the image created by 29-year-old Nurmukhan Janturin. Janturin had a unique ability to play from his heart and soul. Shokan was the officer of the Russian army and at the same time had been fighting for freedom of the Kazakh people. He was the person who laid the foundation of independence of Kazakhstan. Janturin showed this tragic story perfectly. He remained the best actor who ever played the role of Shokan Valikhanov.
И вот этот трагизм судьбы Валиханова он передал в этой картине. То есть, мне кажется, все-таки он остался Валихановым непревзойденным.
He had been following his heart, and that is why he was subjected to repressions. He was a person with a tender, restless, and sensitive heart. He fought for freedom.
Он был очень упрямый человек, своевольный и.
Talking about his creative life, he was a stubborn and unyielding person. If he didn't want to do something, he never did it. Some people didn't like such behavior, and maybe that is why his destiny in the theater was tragic.
Не будет никогда. Может даже он ошибаться, понимаете, что это плохо, но не будет делать этого никогда. Ну, видимо, некоторым людям не нравится, когда человек такой строптивый, и, видимо. Из-за этого, может быть, у него получилась такая трагическая судьба театральная.
Что еще я должен сделать, чтобы доказать, что я...
Should I prove to you that I am a worm or a king? I am a writer and an actor. I think and I rebel.
Я писатель. Я актер. Я мыслю. Знаете ли, я протестую.
Нурмухан Джантурин...
Nurmukhan Janturin lived a short life. He died at the age of 62. It is surprising that in such a short period of time, he did a lot for the former Soviet Union. The beginning of his career was very interesting. At the age of 20, he went to the School of Actors in Almaty. He was offered a role in the Alitet, Goes to the Mountains film. Although he was only 20 years old and didn't have an education, this role was bright. He became an artist and was immediately offered a job at the Oazov Theater. He was offered a lot of roles. He starred in the Zhambul film in 1952 and The Daughter of the Steppes by Shakyan Aymanov. He had been starring in films a lot. However, he understood that he needed to receive a higher education, so he went to Tashkent and graduated from the theater faculty.
Очень активно, так сказать, в театре, значит, то есть это вот, это удивительно, но он понимал, что ему надо учиться, хотя он снялся в 52-м году в фильме «Джамбул» после «Летет», он снялся, значит, в картине «Дочь степей» у Шакена Иманова, он снимался очень активно, но тем не менее он понимал, что ему нужно образование, он наехал в Ташкент, закончил там театральный факультет, вернулся назад.
During his studies in Tashkent, Nurmohan Janturin met his future wife, Margarita, who was an art critic. She was a very loyal wife of an extraordinary person with a stubborn character and a difficult inner world. He will always remain a beloved father, an outstanding actor for his daughters. Remembering her father, Bahid Janturina wrote that one of the films featured horsemen. When she watched it, she was very proud of her charming father, who was second to none in the skill of horse riding. He was part of the nature, and I always felt that he was part of his homeland. I am a human being. I am a human being. The greatest masterpiece of God. I invited him to star in my films twice. Surjike, the Angel of Death, is a film based on the novel by Smagul Yulubayev. This is a story about collectivization and famine of 1932. In this film, he played the part of Bahrattin. In the middle of the film, we ran out of financing and had to leave Almaty. A year ago, we found financing, returned to Almaty and called him up to ask him to continue filming. Unfortunately, we found out that he had passed away. He will always be part of our history. He will remain in our hearts and in the hearts of Kazakhstan residents. Theater footlights are going down slowly and actors are coming out to the audience to the sounds of their applause. Molière Janturin is performing again. Experienced a moment of passion, tears and joy, delight and despair together with a grateful audience. The performance is over, but the destiny of an actor is immortal and talented roles are eternal. This performance is over and it gives the beginning to new creative ascent to the heart and soul of the audience.